Hello, I'm Entrism, and welcome to From the Depths. So, we're going to be starting a new campaign of From the Depths. We're going to go into the campaign mode and going to give a pretty good bashing. We'll have harder enemies, but we'll have a bit more available resources than last time, considering the available resources did kind of devolve into a slugfest. This time, a bit more resources, but we'll still have the hard enemies, and that'll probably be quite an interesting game. Now, one thing I do want to do before we even go into the campaign is I want to have a ship. I want to have a ship ready. I want to be able to go in and be like, right, we're going to destroy the starter ship, we're going to build this ship. Just to be able to actually have something that we can just take, you know, against the enemy. We can go on the offensive straight away. So we're going to be building a ship today. So the first episode is going to be a building episode. Huzzah! I know some of you have been like, actually, I kind of like the building episodes. You know, don't neglect them. It's not all people want shooty-shooty. So, yeah, right. Let's delete all the starring stuff. I don't like it. It gets in the way. I don't see the point in it. Right. So, this is our ship. They may like it, but this one is ours. Currently, yes, it is a block of wood. You make an excellent point, but it will become a lovely ship in its own right. So, we don't want something too big. It's not going to be a diddy-diddy boat by any means. Diddy-diddy boats can't put out enough damage for their size and their value, and they tend to quickly die. Why are you below the surface of the... You're made of wood. There we... You know what? I'm just going to hover it. Why not? Okay. There we go. Finally sneezed. I've been doing that for a while. Right. So, it's mostly going to be wood. I don't want to go over 40,000 metal or wood. That's sort of the hard cap I'm going to set myself. And the idea is it's going to have a few missiles, maybe a few torpedoes, and maybe one cannon. Maybe two, but probably just one, just to get the field of fire right. So, how do I want to play this? No anti-missile defense. Straight up, I don't think we can afford it. Partly in space, but also in terms of everything else. Maybe a dedicated anti-air boat will be something to think about later. But for now, that's probably long enough to be getting on with. So, there are a couple of things I definitely want in this boat. For a start, I want a couple of missile systems. And I want these missile systems to be effectively embedded in the deck, but then tilted so they fire upwards. Now, this does mean that they have a limited arc of fire. They won't be able to fire forwards because they'll be tilted ever so slightly up, but mostly in forward direction. But they will be a lot more shielded than having them on the deck or having them facing straight up. The thing of having them on the deck open, they get really destroyed. Like, they get destroyed really quick. The thing of having them, like, upwards firing means that they have to go a long way up and then turn to get their target. Can't target anyone close and have a longer arc and be easy shot down. There are a number of problems with those ones. So, having a forward firing missile is pretty good. It's a little bit limited in terms of, you know, it can't shoot someone behind you without doing a ridiculous arc, which you'll run out of power in. But, yeah, it should be fine. So we've got to think about how thick the deck's going to be. So we could go for a too thick deck. Let me see. That'd probably work. Yeah, we can make a too thick deck work. Right, so if we put a 5-wide missile launcher in, or would it have to be like 2 threes? Might be 2 threes. I want to make it fairly slim and narrow, so it can be a pretty fast one as well. Because in the early game, you want to be able to think about response and attack at the same time, because you've got limited resources. That said, you know, when you defend, you'll be fairly close to base, because you've got limited territory, but you still want to be able to actually get back. So let's do two, three wide ones. Or we could put a 5-wide one in a torpedo system. Yeah, 5-wide one in a torpedo system. So, torpedo system is going to be somewhere about here. I do tend to like torpedoes. So, let's get a custom missile controller. If I turn it like that, it should be... No, though then that said, if I turn it like that, then the angle at which it fires on enemies is going to be off. Okay, let's do it the silly way, which is... Boop, boop. And then it was something like launch pad, launch pad. Ejector, ejector. Or we could do that. It makes it narrower, can be near the front of the boat. I like that a lot more. That looks better to me. And I want to set you up with fins, fins, torpedo propeller, 1, 2, 3, regulator, no, not regulator, regulator means it can last more than 60 seconds. It doesn't need to. This propeller will go for 60 seconds before it runs out of fuel. That's exactly why I have this ratio. It'll go for a little bit more than 60 seconds, but little bits, it's not worth quibbling about. It needs more of a payload. In fact, I often think that these need quite a substantial payload. Right, so frag, explosive, let's sort this right. You want a sonar on the front. What else do we want? One turn? No, it's facing forwards. Probably do with clipping one on the end. Right, so that'll do for now. Now, this is going to be making sure that this meshes into the front of the hull nicely. So I guess we're actually going to be building the front of the hull. It's a little bit earlier than I normally do for building the front of the hull. I'll do. So, we would want ejectors, lure transceivers, one on the top, one on the bottom. That'd mean we'd want a row of three launch pads, which would mean that we'd want a row of three behind with a missile controller, which would mean we'd need another row behind the AI. So that seems like three back. Or we could put the AI on the side. I don't know. We could go three back. I mean, it'd be pretty long. Yeah, that'll be fine. That means it would be 1, 2, 3. The AI would just need to launch it. It wouldn't actually need any targeting stuff because it would target itself because it's lure. Sure, that should work. Okay, so it would be, say, 6 long for the missile. 1, 1, 1. So that's 9. So we're looking for 9 long block sections. So if we do effectively this, this here, we'd want new object, spin block. Then we'd want to go blocks, metal block, 1, 2, 3. Then we want where is it? Water? No. I want AI. Local weapon controller. AI, not AI, custom missiles. Then we want launch pads. Then ejectors. Do you want them facing forwards like that? Or backwards? Yeah, that's fine. Then we want lure blocks. Kitty, can you stop, like, flicking all the plastic bags I have around? Thank you. You've been told not to. Right, there we go. 5 of those. And then we want staggered fire. Actually, we only want to stagger them ever so slightly. Because I don't want them coming one by one and then just getting picked off. Identify friend or foe, won't need it. Lure can do that. Miss a block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That should be a pretty potent armament. Question is, do we go for 10? And I know everyone at home is probably like, yeah, go for 10. But remember the rule, right? We had a rule in this one. Don't build it too ridiculous. I don't want to build it too ridiculous. That is my want. You know how good I am at keeping my rules like that. Absolutely blooming terrible. Followed with an AI. Which I can't place here, so it has to be a transmitter. Receiver. Bam. Sure. Receive on channel. It should be 2. And there we go. I have our sunken weapon system. Should be ready to go whenever it is required. And it should be able to tilt out the thing. We'll do that with, like, action control blocks, but I don't see a problem with that. Now, if I was to do this properly, I'd flip it from the other one, so it'd be connected to the other side. I'm not going to bother because it's work and effort. Blech. But that would help. I'm not going to bother. That way, if you sustain a lot of damage to one side, currently we'll lose both. In that circumstance, you'd lose less. What I might do is I might attach them to, like, a steel belt that goes around or something, just to prevent this from going all horribly wrong. In fact, I'm going to do that now. Metal block. Metal beam. For now, just those blocks. Then we want a turret. Possibly a command deck. Command deck on the back? Just for a poor field of view? Or command deck here, and then command turret here. We have got a lot of weight on the front, actually, of these bits of metal. We could probably put a turret on the back. Yeah, and if we put a turret too close to these, it'll destroy it. But then... we do need to get an engineer thing. So if we put a command deck, like, here... We'd have space for an engine and everything. Alright. This can be command deck area. Below it, I want engines. So, I'm thinking small, efficient engines and effectively lots of them. Fuel engine, generator, crankshaft, radiator. Cylinder. This is a new design I'm trying that I've been told is relatively good. I haven't had a chance to try it myself yet, so this is all experimentation. Yes, I'm using my terrible Yorkshire accent today. I'm a bit sleep deprived. I'm recording a lot of stuff before I go away. So, I've been, like, non-stop recording for way too long. Hence going slightly crazy. It'd be a miracle if this thing works. Right, carburetor. If I attach the turbocharger... to a cylinder, it produces high efficiency at high engine RPM if the outlet is connected to a carburetor. Right. 800 power. 1% increase to power the radiator flow, which is fine. That shouldn't overheat. It should also have enough to keep it nice and efficient. So these things should be relatively efficient, but each able to provide 800 power. So we've got 1600 right now, which means that's plenty. I could power some shields. And they are efficient at high RPMs. So I'll probably run them at low RPMs. When we get into a fight, I'll have some shields that activate at certain, like, when an enemy is within a certain range, activate shields effectively. And then it'll be running at high RPMs. And that way it'll save a bit rather than having shields running all the time. That's two engines. I could put something here and then have another two at the back. Spread the engines out. Yeah. My question is, what to do with my, my residence, so to speak. Where am I gonna be? Now, I could put my, my position on top of the engines. Just a possibility. And then turret at the back. I could put my position behind the engines, slightly set into the deck. Be a very long craft then, and I actually do worry about that. We're still gonna have to put, you know, ammo store in. I have to put a gun in. The other opportunity is to put, like, guns on the side and just have them not be able to cross each other. It might work. I'm not massively in favor of that because it would make it a lot wider. Just slow it down. It would make the guns would need to be a sort of limited size. I think what I'll do is I'll just put the four engines in the same place. And I'm going to do that by just going new object, no, prefabs, yes, blank one, wipe. I want you to be 3x3. And then, boop. Boop. That should give us a lot of power when we want it. Not necessarily all the time, which is pretty good. But when we want it, we should get some decent response. And we can put, like, a wall in between these to protect them a little bit more if we wanted to. Right. So here is going to be our power and fuel. So, this is where we firewall things again. Remember, unless they've changed ammo barrels can explode a grand total of 3 tiles. So that means we want 3 tiles, which means a gap for safe measure. So the walls are 1 each, and there's a 2 in the middle. That should be fine. And then this is going to be fuel and ammo. This is a very long ship. It's because I had quite a lot of missiles and stuff at the front and torpedoes, which I didn't really factor into the original design, I guess. Debating now, do I put the turrets inside? If we do that, we'll want this to be a narrower ammo space as we go aft. How much we want to in resources? 10,000 metal is fine. I mean, turrets are expensive in terms of metal. That is, you know, that is said, but could be worse. So this is something like, this is probably enough ammo and fuel, right? That's where we'd start putting the propellers on the back. Maneuvering thrusters, we'd have one up here, because the closer you have it to each end, the more powerful they are. One here, probably two there, actually. That means our turrets would effectively go here-ish. You're walking at the bottom, all right. Now, if the turret does detonate, it'd probably take off this chunk with it, because that box would probably go, and this spin block would go. I didn't want the turret to say it was too close. So, right, let's pull that out. It'd be a 3x3, so we're looking at roughly this sort of space for it. Yeah, we can make this work. We'll want the turrets to pop out about here. The reason being that this puppy is going to be up one block, two block. Effectively, the missile's going to be here and the top block is going to be there. So to make sure we've got a decent field of fire, we'll need the firing piece to be up here. So we're looking at that much space for the firing piece. Okay, let's go. So, new object. Two-axis turret, one-axis turret. Then, we can do a sort of zigzaggy method. It's only going to be like 120mm cannon, nothing crazy. Could use a cram cannon. But I honestly think that the fast-firing advanced cannon is probably good for this. Cram cannon's, like, you know, really big cannon, awesome. Slow-firing, but whatever. Right, what's that? If we go for two barrels, 60mm. New. No, I think that's probably a too bigger piece. So let's go for the 118mm. We're gonna do a gauge limit because it's simpler. I would like it to be 118. Oh, for God's sake, I hate the fact that you can type in any number you want, but it then just changes it. Type in 11, it still gives me 118. Overclocking, don't want any overclock. Two barrels, fine. Then... I would like... full shot predictor. Along with autoloader, belt-fed autoloader, because frankly they're amazing. And in the early game, I don't expect fights to go on long enough. Three, along with a clip. Put feeder. Only too long. And I would like it to be a HE penetration head of some kind, like normal. Is it AP cap? Yeah. And if I was to tell you to be 118 long, it would say it's a pierce of 6.6, which is enough to get through light metal, I think. 5 meters explosive. Sure. It's not great, but sure. It's a simple warhead. That's all I want in the beginning. Nothing fancy. Then, oh, you don't have an ammo thingy. That's what that space is for. Inaccuracy, 0.57. I want to improve that slightly. Inaccuracy, 0.4. No, that's fine. I like it. And I believe that is sort of an acceptable turret, although kind of wondering if it should be a little bit more padded. It probably should. Now, let us test you out. It's not a bad gun. I mean, it doesn't have a lot of punch, but it's a very flat trajectory. It's fast, which means it can hit air targets. This gun will actually work. And the reload is not bad either. It's mostly a cooldown kind of thing, I think. Cooldown, 2 seconds, yeah. Can't use the bottom because I need to put the AI there. I mean, yeah, that'll work. The one adjustment I will make is I'll move you to here. Then I'm going to put in a advanced cannon, recoil, 2 meter. And reduces the force by a negligible amount. But sure, we'll do it. Okay. I think you're worthy. So command goes approximately here. So this is like chair. Control. Chair. Firing computer. And then I guess we'd want a glass surround. Just because of the position you look at. I was about to say, we should use steel. It doesn't matter. If this gets hit, it's going down. I don't think there is any point in kidding ourselves. I like it. It's got this kind of rustic aesthetic. I think this is probably one of the best ships I've built in a while. So I've got a little command deck. Got 2 guns. It's a little bit higher than I'd like, but we can easily put a bank of anti-missile missiles on the back. Just stretching back here. We'll put a door in, say, here. I'll need to take this a little bit further back if we're going to do that. I don't like the front hit section here being flat. Makes it too much of a target. Anything that hits it will not deflect. That said, if we use wood, it's not going to deflect anyway. But at least, you know, it'll look like I made an attempt. Whereas at the moment, it just looks... It looks a little bit horrific. I'm not going to lie. It does look a little bit horrific, so... We'll use wood inversion. A wood inversion. Sounds painful. Then... Right. So we want miscellaneous door. So we're going to have doors on both sides of the cabin. I won't use double doors. I do tend to use double doors a lot because single doors can be a pain to get in and out of. But I'm going to use double doors, single doors in this instance rather than, you know, double doors. Because I think what we'll do is we'll need to have the space, effectively. They take up more space. And I know it's not much space they take up, but it'd be enough that it'd be annoying. And then here we have anti-missile missiles, anti-missile missiles, anti-missile missiles, just all the way back. Anti-missile missiles. So anti-missile missiles need... They don't need an AI. They just need to be fixed to the hull and attached to a... Does the AI need to be on the same mainframe? I cannot remember for the life of me. If we do it here and then we tilt it, that should work fine. So I would like to go... New object, spin turn block, then it would be, for now, metal block, and then this would be custom missiles, missile controller, missile controller, it's never missile controller. Missile controls are abominations. Missile controller. Then launch pad. Then block. I could put lure on the bottom, and then it would clip with the one next to it. But that seems a little bit cheaty, so I'm going to put lure on the ejector here. Not lure, I meant ejectors. There's no lure for these. I mean, there probably is a lure script available, I'm just not going to use it. And then down, down. And then down, 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 up. And I don't need an AI here. So we're good. And you should be thruster, no, thin thruster, thin thruster fuel tank, and then anti-missile, missile interceptor. Arming delay. That's fine. And that's fine. And then if we mirror it, the problem is we can't just mirror it, we have to build it again. And I'll tell one of these to go reverse direction. That way they'll like both point out rather than one points out, one points in. And I'm gonna get rid of that. And I'm gonna get rid of one of these. Right. Wood. Wood. Corner. Mirror line! Because I forgot it. Now the reason for that is... Oh, I didn't place it like I meant to. Like that. There we go. It's because I don't want these clipping it as they go out. These are going to have to be launched at quite the angle. They're not going to be the most effective thing in the world. No, I know that. They're not meant to be the most effective thing in the world. They're mostly there because I wanted something anti-missile and these were cheap and fitted the bill. My question is, should I have another one at the back? Basically rotated up. I don't think I could really fit one in. I could fit one in. It'd be three of them. And... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's talk about boat propellers and the placement of them in terms of the hull. Right, so currently our weight is up here. Center mass is in between these two. Not great. I actually prefer it a bit further down. All I might do is just chuck some lead in the hull. Now, lead is expensive. If we have a look at lead, you'll see that it's 60 metal for each individual block. Whereas this is 30 metal for each individual block. I think it's actually gone down in price. The alternative is we could use stone. Stone weighs the same as metal. So I could just be using metal. That said, it's made of natural. Health is... more than wood. Stone's become somewhat viable now. Didn't used to be. Used to be absolutely crappy. You know, I'll use some stone beams. Didn't used to be viable. Right, how are we doing? Still a bit higher than I'd like. It's going to take a little bit of working on that to bring it down. Not great. I think it's time for the hydrofoils. Now, the hydrofoils are going to do an important job, basically stopping us from, like, hitting flat too much. The question is where to place them. We also don't need steering right now. I do need to build steering in. Something I've kind of neglected. And which I will have to pay for in due course, I know. Right. And I believe if we go wood block... I'm going to go and invert it there. Probably looks just slightly better. And then wood block again. Reverse thrust. Reverse thrust. And then we can be like, I want to go hard to the port or whatever. We're turning pretty good. Well, we're listening a little bit as we turn. That's kind of to be expected. We're sitting so far out of the water. Now, if we had everyone at the front, that'd be much increased. Thing is, I don't think I can really inset them anywhere. They look a bit naff, just pegged on the side. I could inset one here. Does cause the nose to rise a bit, but I actually think that looks a lot better in terms of the turn. And it means I can do this, which makes the top look a lot better. You gotta admit, that does look a lot better. Yeah, I honestly think that's a lot nicer turn as well. Sweet. Okay. Now, just gonna stop us bouncing. Couple of hydrofoils at the back, set to always be like 45 degree, would probably help with that quite a lot. That's better. Getting about 20 to 25-ish. 20 to 22, 20 to 23, 21 to 22, 21 to 23. Yeah, that is a pretty good rate. At least I think so. I was going to clad the back in metal. That's the only thing that I haven't done that I am debating. The reason I haven't done it is because, well, the thing works. I don't know if I want to really mess with the winning formula. You know. Seems like it could only go badly. That said, you know, the winning formula is a formula that hasn't actually been into battle. It's kind of like going, oh, it's the winning formula for salt. Well, what do you make it of? Well, I made it up cyanide. You know. Not really, you know, a salt you want to put on your table. Maybe a different type of salt. But, you know, points to the smart aleck, but not points to the person who tried to eat it. Is cyanide a salt? I don't know. I'd have to think about how cyanide's made up. I haven't thought about that for a while. The question is, do we put more weight on the back to defend the ammo supply? I mean, we could just use stone. I've already been using a lot of it. No, we have to use metal. I'm sorry, we have to use metal. I am too worried about what would happen if we just got hit by a few stray rounds. Oh, okay, I'm so close. I will replace just a little bit more, just to be like, I told you so. Okay. There we go. Now, I haven't done a couple of things. Firstly, I need to go around and I need to say to all the missiles to be a certain missile. I need to give a lure block, program the lure block. I need to give it a AI to control it. Let's do a turn, by the way. That one is completely out of the water. Which is fine. I do expect this to start losing some sections of the ship, but whatever. I haven't done shields, which I will do. This machine is designed to have shields. I haven't done quite a few things, actually. But they're all going to be things like, you know, tweaky stuff, like tweaking around with the shields and tweaking around with fields of fire, the turrets that don't shoot each other. There's tweaking around with whatever you want. Spin blocks to make sure the spin blocks, when they see an enemy, pop outwards. Mostly that sort of stuff. So, in the spirit of not taking ages on camera to do stuff that's just going to be me going back and forth and tweaking some minor things, I think this frigate is done. I think it looks like a badass. Now, I don't know when I'll paint it. I might paint it immediately. I might just wait until it's properly in the game before painting. But I actually really like this. I think it looks really damn cool. In the interest of just going, yeehaw, fire everything. I fired the missiles that are inside, but whatever. Whatever. We're cool. I'm happy with that. I'm actually really, really happy with this ship. Look at it. It's going almost 30 meters per second. It looks kind of ridiculous. Like, look how much of it is out of the water right now. We're almost taking off, actually. This is not good. Bye. Might have to limit its speed. That said, it's so funny, I think we might just keep it. What I will do in the meantime is just add a little bit more lead. I know it's probably going to take us over the limit for weight, but it's been so successful so far, I think it's worthwhile doing it. Yeah, that's going to keep it. It's going to slow it down a little bit, but I don't want it, like, aquaplaning, because there's a chance if you aquaplane that you'll get shot in the belly of the ship, and it's not designed to take a shot there. So we'll stick with that. Still going to aquaplane a little bit, but save vehicle. Frigate. Okay. I've been EnterElysium. If you enjoyed playing the light, not subscribe, please consider subscribing. I think this is a badass ship, so let me know your thoughts down below. It's starting to rain, so yeah. Enjoy. Anyway, until next time. If you like playing the light, not subscribe, please consider subscribing, especially considering it is a start of a new series. I know it's the start of a new series and we're in the vehicle designer. But I did want to be able to say, look, this is the thing we're going to be using straight off the bat. Also, let me know your predictions for it. Do you think it's going to work? What do you think its biggest flaws are? I mean, obviously, I think my biggest suspicion about its flaws are it's mostly made of wood. But it's designed to be. It's currently weighing in at less than 40,000 natural, less than 41,000 metal. And I did say the metal's going to be a hard cap. But there's not much I would get rid of. I think if I got rid of this nose piece, we would have more issues. If I got rid of some of the lead, well, we're going to have issues because I need to stay in the water. If I got rid of this, the ammo still would go up. I mean, I'm already pushing it by not having this bit here made of metal. A decent shot, an angle, could probably penetrate through. So we're really running on minimum sustainable right now. I'm going to put in some shield projectors. I'm going to give it some constraints on the turrets that don't shoot itself. I'm going to give it AI for the turrets. I'm going to give it an AI for the control. I'm going to give it AI and Lua for these. And I'm going to give it tweaky, turny blocks to make sure it turns those when it's in range of an enemy. And then when it's not in range of an enemy, it'll turn them back. But until then, stay shiny.